we were actually in meetings, doing some prep work, getting ready for Minnesota, and I had actually seen Tom earlier in the morning at breakfast, and I said, I was hoping you'd have some good news for me this morning, and it was around 7:45, and he was like, "Why, did you hear something?" And I'm like, "No, I haven't." And then 45 minutes later, we're in a meeting at the ice rink in Minnesota, and he pops his head into our team meeting. He's like, "Can I talk to you for a sec, Coach?" And he's like, "Did you know?" And I'm like, "What? No. Like, what are you talking about?" He goes, "I'm good. I can play tonight now." So it was pretty awesome. And certainly added a real nice emotional lift to our team.
Yeah, last night, Caps Twitter, of course, you're actually coaching. I'm watching on TV and following along on Twitter. But Caps Twitter was losing their minds with Tom Wilson getting penalized for interference on his goal, even though Ryan Suter initiated the contact and the collision with Dubnyk, by me looking at the overhead angle, was 90% on the... It's just Tom Wilson getting penalized for being Tom.
I've been in the game for a while as a player and as a coach now, and I can't say I've seen that before. So, credit to obviously Tom's going to the net, and he has to realize, we need him in a number of different capacities. And, you know, the one thing that's kind of doesn't get focused on enough is the way that he can add offense to that top line as well. And, you know, he goes to the tough areas, he ends up scoring. But I have not seen that call very often in my time in the National Hockey League. So that was an interesting one. But we responded well, kept our cool, and were able to kill that penalty off.
Yeah, you did keep your cool, because from watching on TV, you were just kind of laughing. Don't understand what's going on out of the ice.
Yeah, because I've never, like I said, I had never seen it before. So I was, you know, just when you think you've seen quite a bit and you've been in the game for a while, you get surprised, and there's a lot of calls, it seems to be, that kind of leave you wondering exactly what's going on. And that was a difficult one to swallow. A lot of the guys, all you could do at that point is, you know, when the call is made, I mentioned one thing to them that I just, are you sure? Like, I haven't seen that before. And they're like, yep, that's what happened. And I'm like, all right, I'll save my energy for other fights as the game goes on with the referees. But it's always something different, but it made for, at the time, a little bit of comic relief on our bench, because we were all surprised by it.
Now, Coach Reardon, everybody knows what Tom Wilson brings to the table on that first line, his physical nature, but maybe undervalued is penalty kill. And your penalty kill was great last night. And Tom Wilson, talk about his role on the penalty kill and how that unit is faring generally.
Yeah, he's, that's been an area that we've struggled this year and something we're working on, and we've made some adjustments to that, some changes to how we did it in the past. Just, I'd say, primarily because of some different personnel that are involved. And, you know, we've had to go through it for the most part this year, obviously, without Tom up until last night. And he's, you know, probably our second leading minute guy from last year that was returning. And the number one guy was Jay Beagle. So, we don't have him any longer. So we had to, because of the certain personnel that we have now, we wanted to adjust to how we killed. And something that, with the new coach, Scott Arneal, brought in some new ideas and some different thoughts on that. And, it's something we're going through a little bit of a learning process on. But for Tom, he's out first over the boards for us. Obviously not the guy taking the face off. Although that is an area he's getting better at, but he's done it for a while. He's been in, big game situations and had big kills, and he's willing to block shots. He's skating so good. He's got quite a good stick. He's rangy, and I think he's able to disrupt a lot of plays that way. So, and he's so strong. So there's an really make him a great killer, and it's an area he's grown his game over the last couple of years. So that was a huge to have him back in that situation, and that helped us kill off 5 of 6 last night. So hopefully we're headed in the right direction there.
Joined by Todd Reardon, head coach of the Washington Capitals. They face the Winnipeg Jets tonight. How much easier is it for you now with Willie back to get the line set the way that you and the rest of the coaching staff want them. There's been some juggling with the lines early in the season here.
Yeah, there definitely has been, trying to find the right combinations, you know, with what's going to work and give us the best chance to have success. We seem to be able to string together a game or two, but no real consistency. So, you know, you've got to, you know, take a look at some different options. And early in the season is the best time to do that, especially when you're involving some young players. And, you know, you've got to give them an opportunity to either win those jobs or lose those jobs. And, you know, so sometimes you have to go through a little bit of a learning curve. Obviously, you're quite familiar with what as a coach, what a guy like TJ Oshie is going to do, but you know, you're maybe not as certain as, you know, how a guy that even younger players are going to do, as a Travis Boyd coming, you know, back from an injury, or you've got, you know, how's Verona going to be, and Burkowski, and young players, when you move them into top six roles, are they going to be able to be consistent with that spot? So it's definitely a work in progress, and that some of that is to do with, you know, hoping that young players can, you know, take that step to move into that upper echelon and those top two, you know, top six group of forwards that we have. And sometimes it takes a little bit of in and out movement with them to be able to get the consistency that we need. But man, it's made it a lot easier on me last night to have him back in that spot. And I think everybody just slots nicely into their roles there. And it makes us such a tougher team to defend against. Now we've got four lines of guys that can add offense and can defend as well. And, you know, you saw the results last night were real favorable for us as we got scoring up and down our lineup.